gotta stay in or something.
Whoa.
And we back. Hey. I'm feeling real good on this Western Sun Hill Country.
You gotta reintroduce yourself.
Like, body
I am. My body feels real good. I got a new flavor. It's apricot.
I'm on three.
Well, it's my third one.
It's a different one. I have apricot. We got... Pop Darby in the building.
Uh-huh.
We got Stupid Stokes in the building.
Hey, this shit strong
as
shit.
We got DZ Miyake in the building. Over here
that's
helping
the Spike Lee.
The hood's like Lee. Jeez. 15, 20 plus years. So I gotta say, goddamn, shout out to, can I say Latino?
You gotta introduce him like Steve Harvey brought out his
Because he really coming through with the new mixtape, and they gotta know Lil Terry on the new mixtape.
Yeah, bro,
That's some real, you gotta really know me.
Yeah. They gotta know Lil Terry on this new mixtape.
That's some family hood shit.
Okay.
Alright, so shout out to Creflo in the building right now.
Shout out to Creflo in the building right now.
Hey,
these niggas and my niggas just came in this old too. Shout out to Gilo Sins. My new ad lib is Cash. You know what I'm saying? I was saying the whoa, but everybody be saying.
So you just changed your name?
Yeah, I'm Cash. Nah, my name Creflo, but my ad lib is Cash.
Cash. Okay, I like it.
Okay. So Creflo. I'm gonna call you Creflo.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, I'm gonna call you Creflo too, because that's all I know.
Yeah, I gotta go with the T.
I don't even know your real name.
I can't be telling people my real name.
Okay, can you describe the cheese?
What you mean?
What is cheese?
That's the squad. I just gotta let it be known.
What team cheese mean?
Can you describe? Everybody act like my language don't make sense.
I never knew what team cheese was.
All right, team cheese is this. It's everybody do all kind of shit. You know what I'm saying? But it's all under one umbrella. You know what I'm saying? I rap. He got his thing going on. Chimo got his thing going on. And it's a lot of us. People don't know that. You feel me?
How many of
shit,
you
I don't know. We got little homies. Big homies.
We got a mountain and a molehill worth of people.
But everybody do my partner Mike, he hoop. You feel me? Low box. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just everything under one.
So how did y'all come up with this name?
From saying we had the word cheese so popular, like one time we was like trending on Twitter, like number one, like every college and everything was saying we had cheese hoes.
Cheese
Tuesdays.
Hoes.
We just be talking about hoes.
I forgot cheese hoes went viral on Twitter. Yeah, Twitter
came. So cheese hoes, is that a good thing or is it a bad thing?
No, you don't want.
Let me explain to you.
You don't
cheese, cheese is. It got so many meanings. Like, I could be like, what's up, cheese? Like, that's what's up, my nigga. Okay. I could be like, damn, she cheese. That means she weak. You feel me? Like, it's just,
she could be fine and cheese at the same time.
No.
This might got three bunions on her pinky toe.
Yeah, but she fine. Cheese. It'd be like, nigga be like, she cheese, but nigga hit, though.
You got a point.
You know what I'm saying? We got so much lingo. Like, we really, some lingo words, bro. Like, we been... We really started a lot of that
since Woods.
Like, yeah, shout out to Carter G. Goddamn, like, we always been them popular niggas in school.
Okay.
Best dressed niggas in school.
Yeah, I think y'all ain't going to know. Texas
lingo?
You think lingo is like a Texas thing? A lot of people.
Everybody got lingo.
We got so much words.
We can have a conversation.
Like, yeah, just south side alone, I can name like three things that came out of the south.
Bro, we can have a conversation. You might not know what we're talking about, but we know what we talking about. You know what I'm saying?
I said shout out to Carter G. Wilson. I also want to say shout out to every word. That's
right.
I see you came through with
I'm from Dead End
on his chest and diamonds. That's what I want to ask you about. Growing up, since we asked them, I'm going to take their question and swing it to you since Dead End family is in the building. Yeah. What did your hood mean to you? Especially since you coming up under the SUC.
My hood mean a lot to me because I be feeling like I got a point to prove.
Yeah.
And my old man died when I was like 2 1 3, you feel me? Like, but everybody in my hood know my daddy, like from being fly flashy, like, you know what I'm saying? Then my uncle. KK, who started the group, you know what I'm saying, Dead End Alliance with Fat Pack, Hawk, Screw, and himself, you feel me? So I've always been around.
The original SUC.
Yeah, you feel me? Yeah. I always been around Fat Pack and Hawk and all that type of shit, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I kind of seen the shit manifesting. When I was growing up, like, my uncle was like one of the niggas in the hood who had all the bread, you know what I'm saying? Like, so I seen a lot growing up, you know what I'm saying? So shit, like I said, I had a point, I got a point to prove for him. Went to jail for like 10, 12 years, you feel me? So I really be rapping for them to keep their name and their legacy alive, you feel me? So
when I met you, you weren't rapping. How long have you been rapping?
Well, this is my little kinfo, this TC Nino, but we been rapping as kids, like just, like my uncle was in the feds, like we'll take paper balls and put them in the tape player and press play and record and be recording over shit, freestyle, so he and us in the feds over the phone type shit, you know, karaoke type shit. Nah, but I mean, a nigga just started taking it serious like a couple years ago.
How serious are you taking rap right now? Because you went on a drought.
Hiatus.
You went on a hiatus.
That shit costs money, bro. And it ain't even that. People Star Wars 2 just now kind of growing. You feel me? Like into a brand. Like motherfuckers fuck with it. Like I be out and about motherfuckers. Oh, you Star Wars? Oh, I fuck with that. Ooh, that whole classic. You know what I'm saying? That's my first tape ever. You know what I'm saying? But
I gotta congratulate you on that because it was Metro booming.
I really went damn near broke with that shit. You feel me? Like, me and Chimo really was on the tour bus with Southside listening to Beach. You know what I'm saying?
808 Mafia.
Like, you know what I'm saying? I really was fucking with Don Cannon. Met him, talked to him a couple times, really talked it up with him. We was in the mall, you feel me? Like, bro, I don't take pictures with niggas because I don't be on no meat ride and shit. You feel me? But I really have been. We was in the studio with Scarface, like, you know what I'm saying? But I ain't dropped Star Wars 2 because I want to get better with my flow. Like, I want to talk about different shit. I want to make real music instead of just keep putting bullshit out, you feel me?
So what's one of the things that you want to advance in?
Just my rhyme pattern, just elevate my whole flow. Like, I want to make real music. Real music, like, you know what I'm saying? Not just a bunch of I went in the studio and done some shit. I want my tape to flow like a movie, you know what I'm saying? Like, because I feel like ain't nobody in Houston out of reach. Okay. I mean, Slim Thug and them got money and shit, but Houston ain't got no big-time rapper like talking about. You got Travis Scott, but ain't no nigga just from the South
Side.
Really
claim
him.
She's kind of weird.
I mean, I'm fucking Travis Scott, though.
Oh, my God.
But I'm saying, like, nobody's out of reach. We don't have Futures. We don't have Jeezys. We don't have J.T.
South Park, them niggas different anyway.
So, I just be feeling like if I work right and I really put forth effort in my crib, I can be something with this shit. You feel my kinfo done be on my ass.
And the man really got some.
I feel like I got a story to tell.
He really got something, bro. From being with Hawking, like my uncle for real.
Right. The Kiki's like and all them. Like that was my daddy best friend type shit. You know what I'm saying? Like Kiki's and I really know these people. I don't be on no fan shit. Like they see me, oh, what's up, Latell? Feel me? Like, I've been around these people all my life type shit.
So I heard you say you spent a lot of money in your promotion. And you promoted Store Run initially hard. So do you feel like you received what you was putting into it? Do you see yourself getting that back?
It's, like I say, it's just now starting to grow. Like, I'm finna hit you with some merchandise. Store Run 2, I'm gonna have a little movie. Like, people just now starting to accept it was a good-ass tape.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But you gotta like the criticism first.
I don't be tripping because I know shit take time. Like Rich Homie say, before he blew up his tape that he done, it took 3 years for that motherfucker to blow up that one tape.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I don't try to rush shit. You know what I'm saying? I don't be sad about, oh man, my shit ain't blew up, or I know shit take time. The people who getting they just do right now been rapping for years. Ski Tate's blowing up right now because he been rapping for years.
Right.
Even the South Walker, whatever, but they been rapping for a long time. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I don't just think I'm going to get in the game and boom, I'm going to blow up because shit don't happen like that.
But like Pop said, rapping in Houston is really like entrepreneurship. Like you really got to put three years in at least.
It's like college.
Yeah, you got to put 3 years to make in and then count. You'll finally kind of see it a little bit. And then maybe like in your fifth year you can see
it's discouraging at times.
I call it
a
college.
Yeah,
it is. It can't be.
You be like, damn, I know I'm jamming harder than this shit. You know what I'm saying? But Like, I ain't doing no dick riding, bro. I ain't finna be acting like I fuck with niggas. If a nigga do something for me, I already pay you, bro. Cause I don't want no favors. I don't need you saying you done nothing for me, bro.
Don't come back out.
You know what I'm saying? Cause niggas be, oh, yeah. Ooh, nah, nigga, I paid you. Nigga, I wouldn't ride your dick, nigga. I needed your service, nigga. I paid you, nigga. Right. I came in square bitches with my cash.
Bro, did right. that.
You know what I'm saying? But now I ain't paying a nigga for shit.
Okay, I can respect
that. You know what I'm saying? I ain't paying for my song play. I ain't paying to perform with your shit. I ain't doing none of that, bro.
Graduated.
You know what I'm saying? I know better now. It's rules to the game, you feel me?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Everything is a lesson. Yeah. So you got a big lesson with your first go round.
For sure. But we was really rocking shit though, like Limelight. We put on live ass shows and that motherfucker. Stay down for the come up, bro.
Nope. Really
I'm team cheap, but I'm stay down for the because stay down for the come up is the new whole hood movement. You feel what I'm saying? Like when I was a kid, it was DA Dead in the Lines. You feel me? But it's a new era and shit. It's Stay Down for the Come Up now. That's who run the hood right now.
So what is Stay Down for the Come Up? What?
Shit, you stand down till you come up. You feel me?
It's not a click.
That's what the hood on right now.
How did that come about? How did that start?
You got to
have Logo. You want to say something about that? Come on, Logo, tell us.
It just pretty much started by just us getting together. You know what I'm saying? Trying to put something together and shit. That was the thing. You know, I was already on Stay Down for the Come Up, working, going to school before I even started rapping. You know what I'm saying? Been probably about 3 years before I've been rapping, but it was just something that we came up together. Then shit, one down, one up. Stay Down for the Come Up. You know, we stand down and come up. So it one down, one up.
Tell us how you got to tell them that. Like, it was the first thing that all the hood cliques
came
was rocking.
Yeah, was rocking.
I was about to say, because then it ain't nothing but a bunch of apartments.
It's a bunch of cliques.
It's a bunch of apartments.
Everybody be from the first one. All the everybody from the downstairs, everybody
really don't rock. That made everybody start rocking with each other. You know?
Train over there tripping.
Yeah.
Do we
need it? Now she next to the
door. It's a whole lot of sales.
I made a spill of water. Yeah, I made a spill of water. Aquarius. Hey, shout out my nigga Aquarius.
Yeah, my birthday Saturday.
What you doing for your birthday, T?
We going to the booty club.
No.
He fucking with me.
Yeah.
I got no time.
Yeah, I go to DC Friday. I'm a missy, so you got to really tear it up for me.
We'll be turning up Friday. Too.
You know
what we do, baby.
Yeah, and my boys got a show Friday. Where is it?
Yeah, we at the Mirage.
That was Fast Money.
Fast Money.
Yeah,
okay, so give us details
early
on the show.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, damn. Let me see. Man. I ain't gonna make it up.
Stay ready,
okay,
so you
we'll
don't
come
never
back. We'll come back for the details on the show.
Ask me some questions.
So, what you doing for Super Bowl?
Shit, I don't know. They taxing out here for Super Bowl, my God. Damn. Nigga want to turn up, but shit. Really, I'm trying to get me some money, Super
trying
Bowl.
To
I'm,
okay.
Everything, I'm customer service, brain. Goddamn. Everything brain. Is for sale.
So that's the next take, customer service.
Yeah, customer service kind of like
what's customer
the
beats.
Service? You know what I'm saying? I'm just jumping on niggas' beats. Whenever I feel like get out of car, I go to the studio, jump on something.
You are you me? Writing or are you freestyling with this one?
Lately, I usually write. I mean, I freestyle in my head, then I write, jot down, and add to it. But lately, I've been booting up, and I've been just going to the studio getting on shit.
Now, you know, we got lingo. They don't know what booting up is.
Oh, booting up. Booting up means getting on the tab.
Take out.
Boot up. Yeah.
I never knew that.
Yeah, ain't nobody gonna jump.
I got booed up.
I didn't even want to tell y'all what I thought.
My Southwest, my Mac Money, Steve Tice, all of them, I got booed up from them. You feel me?
Okay.
Just like my man said, he on the north, everywhere, like. I be on the Southwest, them my niggas. You know what I'm saying? So, like, we kind of tie everything together. You know what I'm saying?
Mac and cheese.
But that's like I said, we already doing this.
B, what is mac and cheese? Describe to the folks what mac and cheese is.
To the Southwest, you know what I'm saying? We locked in. It's mac and cheese. My brother's G's dying to do their time or die in the streets, man. You know, real niggas unified, bro.
How y'all coming up with this? Whatever comes to mind.
It's Mac Money Gang. Shout out to Mac Money Gang from the Southwest, the real Southwest. Shout out to Team Chief South Park, the real South Park. You know what I'm saying?
And, oh, yeah, Dead End, bro. I'm going to say Dead End is like third. Well, you know how when niggas, sometimes people don't even be from places. When they just pick a place, yeah. That's how dead it is.
They hard up. We like,
Third Ward like that too. It be a bunch of motherfuckers ain't from Third Ward, right. But they be like, man, I'm from Third Ward.
I'm from Detroit.
Yeah. That's how dead in historic. Like Third Ward, I can say
it's a milestone.
Yeah, like that's one of the hearts of the city. Just like when people feel like they come to Third Ward, that's the heart of the city. Dead end is too. You feel me? And that's what we trying to do. We trying to put our hood back on the map in a global port. Cause in 20 years early, when that dead end line city, that's a classic city, bro. You know what I'm saying? We trying to build on that and put our hood back on the map. Cause like when Jay Prince them have block parties and Chris Brown them made them and shit.
Right.
The Southside need that too, bro. Yeah.
So what's your plan to get that in action?
Shit, hopefully we all come together and do some big things and get noticed.
For but you can't say hopefully. You guys have
we to get noticed. Because my man, trapping like really a hit.
I'm just ready to come to the block party.
My nigga, on the regular hit, hit him up a hit, trapping like a hit, you feel me? Nigga, we putting it out, but we ain't getting adjusted. Do on the radios and all that type of shit. You feel me? Like, and really,
why do you think that?
Niggas politics. Politics. Niggas gotta change the. We gotta stop.
Niggas know what's like. I fuck with Big Thong. Eric. People really from Eric. Really from dead end, bro.
Right.
All his people really from dead end. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, Big Thong, real nigga. Big Thong be on my ass like. Bro, you be bullshitting. You feel me? Don't miss the wave. You feel me? Like, I fuck with them. You know what I'm saying? But I don't be on that. Glorifying it or putting it out for everybody, but I know if I get my shit in order and do shit the right way, it ain't no telling what can happen.
Hey, can I hopscotch on you? That's people ask me that shit, bro. Hey, man, like I be telling these niggas. You feel me? It's real simple, bro. Work.
Yeah,
you
gotta work.
Don't ever stop working. I don't give a fuck. What the fuck you gotta do, pimple bitch? Whatever the fuck you gotta go to make
man,
this shit happen.
I'm back working.
Man, no, listen what I'm saying. I'm not promoting how I do it. I'm promoting that I'm doing it.
Yeah.
Doing it is the hard part. You just gotta go and understand that if you keep going, they just gonna get up out of
the hustlers don't stop, they keep going.
Man, they either gonna join you or they gonna warn you. At the end of the day, they can't stop a bitch ass thing. You gotta go around them. It's chicks. You can't stop working.
That's how I look at the world, period. I feel like I'm a person and I'm playing a chess game. Any move I
talk some
on
good
on
shit.
Man,
I want
to
talk some good shit.
Talk
you
to
feeling
me.
Yourself? We talking about
so what you want to talk about?
Talk to him.
He asking you. All right,
look, this is what I want. You came in with a double cup. How long you been seeing oil? Because I ain't never not seen oil my whole life. And niggas be acting like he's the first to be oil.
Listen, bro, I can really tell you the first time I ever sipped oil, bro.
Talk to
me. When my mama stayed in the corner apartment in Broadway Square, you feel me? All my Uncle Allen was over there. That's
the corner one.
The corner part. Okay. Don't be a menace first came out type shit.
Haha, to society while drinking gin.
Yeah, you feel me? Everybody in that hoe watching, I'm in that hoe. I'm the only kid in that hoe. They, man, this nigga tripping, you feel me? Man, get that nigga a cup, you feel me? Pour me a little cup in the glass, and he been on ever since, shit.
All zippers.
Grandma was an all zipper.
Yeah. Grandma
used to hit Uncle KK full. I'm talking about it's been
y'all
in
seen
my blood
them stealing
since youngster, you feel me?
It's fake oil out here right now, though.
Baby. Y'all bloodline.
I've been seeing it. What does that mean?
Bro,
when they say it's fake oil,
it ain't a lot of
unclean
sauce.
So how can you tell?
Niggas is reselling the oil, bro. Like
when you still
it's
up,
thin and all kind of.
You didn't say it don't rest on the bottom. It just floats like water.
Okay. How can you tell if it's fake?
When I hit it. First off, when I get the bottle, and I look at the seal, you feel me? I can tell, that boy hit me with that unclean sauce. You feel me?
You look at the bottom and tell what?
The bottle. Yeah, niggas is buying bottles and reselling the bottles.
Okay, so how can you naturally just tell?
If you really sip all, bro, like when you get, you know all. You know when you get the bottle, you've been buying bottles or whatever you've been doing, you know, like, man, then you crack that boy, it's the seal, it's the taste.
So
it's
if y'all
the thin
or
the thin or something.
So them little new 8 ounce.
Come on.
Niggas getting activated.
Hey, they got why y'all still sipping all if y'all saying it's some bad stuff.
I gotta talk to the Jew, man.
Talk to the juice man. Talk to the king.
Somebody got to get up.
I'm going to
tell you.
I'm
going to tell you. First of all.
Catch a mic, Red. Catch a mic. Yeah.
First of all, nigga, let me talk to you, because I'm a real live sipper, too. Yeah. Like, I do this, I itch when I can't find it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. All right, look. First of all, half these dudes ain't no sippers, because they've never experienced bar. Yeah. Nigga, you ain't
bar?
Never had nigga. That's big, that's the mo. That's the granddaddy. That's the OG,
not
triple
activist.
OG. This before Al Former. You know what I'm saying? It's for Al Former.
Y'all have to break this down for the people that don't know.
Big Mo is the bar baby.
Okay, if you're not from Houston, you watch this.
If you're not from Houston, you probably never had bar. If you're not from Houston,
I understand that, but y'all have to explain. So when Big Mo came out with the bar baby, what was he talking about?
The bar, the drink. That was the bar. You used to say bar on the bottle.
That's a brand.
You used to say it's a brand. You feel me? That's the original purple with the shits in. Like, that's it.
It just used to say bar on the bottle?
No. It had the whole parenthesis with codeine.
Okay.
And at the bottom in parentheses, most of the time it had parentheses.
Yeah, that's the brand.
Bar.
The company.
Bar. Okay.
The
bar baby.
Yeah.
Okay.
It had it's natural says bar on there. And
so
then after
time,
that,
it just.
After that stopped coming. Then you had Al Former. Now, Al Former was the last.
We getting drink class.
Yeah, Al Former was the last line of purple
that
the OG niggas was really like
Al Former
fucking with. Al, you know niggas my lingo and shit.
Okay,
but you know they know what I'm talking about. Al Former.
Okay.
Pharmaceuticals.
And that it had the Pro-Med, red thing was woo. It had the black bottle, purple label. When the brother go, you know what I'm saying? That was it. You feel me? After they start making the ball. And after they start making the ball, you feel me? You had the Al Former. And after that for Al Former, then that's where activists hit. You feel me? Where activists is a bust down at Al Former. Al Former was a bust down at the bar.
Mm.
So each one get weaker.
Now it's all gone.
It's all water.
Now yeah, you
so
ain't
if it's
number
all gone, gone. What y'all sipping on?
I'm sipping.
Well, you got okay. T said he gonna tell me the best drink out.
Really, I'm gonna tell you the best drink, bro. That nigga sleep on. It's a drink called Soon.
Yeah,
it got promethazine with codeine in it, bro. It's thin, so a little. It's like it's kind of green. It's like
green.
It's like. But it ain't green though. It ain't MGP High Tech green. You feel me?
Shout out to MGP High Tech.
It got permethrin and codeine in it. You feel me? It's kind of thin, so a nigga will get it and be like, man, this is thin.
I don't think it's
wrong if it ain't green.
That's the best shit going. And that Trishan, it's made by a company called Sun.
Shout out to Stowe Run because we made a lot of Stowe Run off of MGP and High Tech.
To me, I like
no. Nah, I ain't do none of that. I don't know what he's talking about. That's a lot.
Hashtag.
Pop Dog been tripping. I don't know what Pop Dog been talking about.
Okay, so y'all gave us a lot of knowledge. We are for a commercial break. We'll come back. What up? Welcome back to Southern Hospitality. It's your girl, Trine Bean. We back with Super J, Pop Darby, Stupid Stokes, Miss Asia Rion, DJ Miyake on the camera.
Whoa.
And we got Creflo and basically all of Dead in the
room.
Yeah,
TC Nino
and
you.
Okay, before we go into any other subject, I want y'all to get y'all social media so people can find y'all, reach out to y'all, find y'all music. And TC Nino, we going to talk to you because you're a new artist, goddamn.
Hold up, man.
Yeah, I'm on Instagram, Creflo, KREFLO _, Twitter, Young Creflo, YUNG Creflo.
I'm TC _ Nino, TC Team Cheese Nino, you know. Go follow me on the ground.
Okay.
Red.
Y'all come get a mic.
At Dead End _RDD, because I'm twice the man your daddy would ever be.
Y'all follow your boy, man. Stay Down Logo, man. Stay Down _logo. Really just type in Stay Down. You can see the whole team, though, man.
Okay,
you
know? Shout out to Stay Down for the come up. Shout out to Team Cheese.
Stay Down for the bands. STADYLWN, number 4.
D.A. Ben.
Ben!
This is our Puerto Rican.
This is
our Puerto Rican. This
is our Puerto Rican. We got about six C's on that hoe. I, Cheese, we gonna ask you, what is the meaning of stolen?
Stolen? Really, my man Gillo helped me make it. I was trying to see what I was gonna name my shit. My boy Gillo kind of helped me, but stolen is... anything like you going to the stove, get you some ice for your lean, get you some cigars, some sandwich bags, or going to the jewelry store, or you going to the shop with your plug, I don't give a damn, you going to get Similac for your baby or whatever. Like, everybody in the world make a store run every day, bro. So that's why I feel like the brand is building, you know what I'm saying?
It's very
like,
relatable.
Yeah, it's relatable. Yeah. Who don't make some kind of store run, you know what I'm saying? For anything,
I
it don't matter what
you
do.
Two, three times a day.
Hey, this is my real partner.
Definitely.
He seen me the drunkest I ever been in my life.
You look pretty drunk right now.
Nah, you had a hell of a night in Las Vegas. Right, we ain't gonna talk about that.
Yeah, we ain't gonna talk about that.
I fucked up his whole room. Like,
What happened in Vegas?
I ain't embarrassed. I shit in the room.
In his room, with my room.
Oh my God!
You gotta see the footage.
The biggest event in the world at the time.
This is the biggest fight in the world. This is Mayweather and Pacquiao.
MGM Grand.
I gotta carry this nigga out to my float upstairs.
I never drunk whiskey before, so they give me like 14 shots of whiskey. Me and Gillo, bitch ass.
He can't drink with me. I'm that young nigga, man.
In the middle of the fight, we got to wheelchair this nigga to my room, bro.
Y'all wheelchaired him?
Wheelchaired him to my real love, though.
That's my real love, man.
I'm going to miss this $1 million fight to take your drunk ass upstairs.
Hey, he left me up there, but it's all
right. I got you right. I put you in the bed, and I'm gone. After the fight, I check back.
That's a real friend. You put that nigga in the bed.
Bro, the
that
nigga,
is a real friend.
Bro, the nigga was
out of there.
Wheelchair.
I don't even remember.
So that means y'all gotta come with us to the Chris Brown and
we going.
Chris Brown and I can't even think of the other nigga
names. Big Soldier. Big
Soldier.
King Draco.
I don't know.
Speaking of, kind of want to ask y'all about people. You know, claiming hoods and like you say earlier, everybody just claiming it in.
You want
to
know what's funny, bro? It's funny how people can claim everything, bro, but I can pull my birth certificate on
you.
It'll say 11-9-11-9-MLK. And it'd be funny because, you know, I don't even claim that. You feel me? I don't claim no hoods, you feel me? I claim
everything. A motherfucker,
I'm
not from the
hood.
My old man died in
there. You know what I'm saying? So I don't claim no one section. I claim.